Cupcake de yuca. Cupcake de empanada. Guaya la yuca. First, you grate the yuca, which is a root vegetable. We use it a lot in Puerto Rican food, and the Taino Indians used to make cassave type of bread out of it, a flat bread. Then you grate it, you keep grating it. So we're gonna make first what's called la masa. If it's too wet, you can take one of those cooking, like linen cloths, and you squeeze out the excess. But this isn't too wet, this is just fine. It becomes a pasty type of dough thing. This is gonna be the, what would be like the outside of the cupcake. And then we'll have some pork filling, which we have to prepare the meat. They'll have pork, a pork filling inside. I've added some anato, achato, anato, achote. As a coloring. A little bit of olive oil. I like the taste it gives it. And it betters the consistency of the masa. And spread out this color evenly. The color's not really necessary, but we're used to seeing yuca cooked in a certain color, which is, it would be this color. We can actually have it make it white also. It would just look like a white cupcake, and then you can decorate it with whatever you want on top. And use whatever you want as a filling also. I'm using pork. Ground pork as a filling, but you can use anything you want. You could fill it with vegetables if you're not into meat, with fish, with whatever you want. I'm gonna even out this color a little more. I'm gonna add half a tablespoon of minced garlic, fresh garlic, into the masa. And a pinch of salt. Just a pinch. Spread the garlic evenly also. I'm using this, but pretty soon I'm just gonna stick, my hands are clean. So, how I usually really do it, is I do this. It's the best way to get everything mixed in more evenly. Masa de yuca. As I said before, I'm gonna be adding the ground beef, which I'll prepare shortly. And the ground beef will have spices. Of course, peppers. I'm the pepper man. The sweet peppers, you know, not hot peppers. I got a hot sauce, homemade hot sauce on the side if I want to add to it. And that'll be it for now. Now we're gonna prepare the ground pork. This is fresh ground pork from my local butcher shop. Esto es cerdo molido fresco del carnicero local. Te voy a echar ajo. Te voy a echar. Capers, espárragos, no espárragos, no. No me acuerdo ahora ni cómo se llama esto en español. pescabarrado, le decimos en Puerto Rico. Y en algunos lugares, creo que en España, le dicen capotes. Capers. Acá es pescabarrado. Ahora... un poquito de pimiento rojo y verde. Y... un poquito de orégano de una mata que tengo allá atrás. Por cierto, se está muriendo. Orégano fresco, seco. I'm browning the meat. Estoy preparando la carne. Que se cocine. And like I said before, como dije anteriormente, puedes hacer el relleno de lo que guste. De carne res, de pollo, de langosta, de camarones, de vegetales. De lo que más a usted le guste, puede hacer el relleno. Lo sazona a su gusto. Estas son sugerencias y manera de que yo preparo las cosas, cada cual, como siempre digo, prepara sus cositas a su gusto. Le voy a añadir cebollines a la carne. I'm gonna add some leeks to the meat.
Papa, potato, potato, batata, batata dulce, sweet potato, white sweet potato.
This is the one that we usually use in Puerto Rico.
La batata blanca dulce.
Calabaza, calabaza, Spanish squash. Calabaza seeds. Calabaza seeds, la semilla de calabaza. You know where these are going, right? Even though it has the most nutrition, the skin of the calabaza, I removed it. Because for what I'm planning on doing with it, to me it doesn't go along. But when you use the calabaza in other stews, like bean stews or any type of stew, you can leave a lot of people leave the cáscara. We're gonna put in a pot with some water, the potatoes, the calabaza, and the sweet potato, the Spanish sweet potato, the Puerto Rican patata. We're gonna boil all of this, and instead of mashed potatoes, simple mashed potatoes, we're gonna have un majado de batata, papa, y calabaza. Gonna have mashed potato, sweet potato, and the squash. And since this, the sweet potato is gonna give it a nice little sweetness to it. We're gonna take the cupcake pan and put one of these non-stick products on it. I got the olive oil type. Then we'll proceed filling up the little cups on the sheet with yuca. Don't fill it up too much. You make a little dent where the filling is gonna go. There we go. There we go. This one I might have filled too much. Como vieron, le eché un poquito de spray de eso de aceite de oliva para que no se peguen los cupcakes después de hecho. Ahora estoy pasando la masa de yuca aquí a los pasitos. Le hago un espacio para la carne de cerdo. Y luego añadimos un poco más de yuca como para cubrirlo. Aquí le falta un poquito. mention, I forgot to mention something very important. Algo muy importante se me olvidó mencionar. For the first, let's say, like 15 minutes, keep covered. Then, in the last like 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 5 minutes, depending on your oven, then you remove the aluminum foil and stick it back in and let them brown out on the top. But you gotta keep watching so they won't be overdone. Porque si los dejas sobre cocinar, if you let them all get overdone, they'll be like rocks. Ya está hirviendo el majado. Hice bastante. Hice los 6 cupcakes y el majadito. Porque le voy a dar a mi hermana Cani. Y ahí para Manuel, su compañero. Cupcakes. I just dropped in some butter, like 1/4 of a stick, so it can melt into the majado. To the mash. It's becoming a mash. Mantequilla. Mantequilla de verdad. No de dieta. Just checking on them. I forgot to inform you before to make sure that when you put the aluminum foil on it, to spray it con a nonstick también. Or you can use like plain olive oil or butter, whatever. Que le echen un poquito del spray ese para que no se pegue el papel de aluminio de la from the top of the cupcake.